All right, I hit start streaming. I'm gonna go tweet about it. Why don't you go tweet about it? This is my new insult.
Which account am I on?
I also have an idea of what to say when I think something's cool. And I'm just gonna start saying that things are soup.
Love it.
Twitch.tv/immediateTVNIST.
Oh, no echo, please, tablet.
I'm glad that there are other podcast editors that are just like, yeah, I don't know what the fuck a compressor is. Like, I know what it is and what it does, but, like, I don't use one. If I need to make something... Well, go ahead.
Who's talking about compressors today?
It's just, like, been around. I've seen it lately. Like, just today I saw Charlie and Jeremy and some other people talking about it. Because Charlie uses a compressor at the end when they're done editing.
Okay.
Pre-pod. But, like, So, and I saw, like, a tweet about it, like, a week ago saying, like, oh, voice acting friends, if you do this on your audio, it'll make it better. And I was sitting here like, yeah, sure, you could put a compressor over the whole thing, or you could go to the part that's a little bit too loud and just negative amplify it, which is what I do.
Right, right. Like, why do that to, like, your whole track when you could just, like, isolate the trouble areas?
Like, I already have to go through it anyways. Might as well just hit the thing. So I have on the stream right now my scoundrel character that I was playing for a while.
Cute! Aww.
Swishy cape.
Lando would be very, very proud of your swishy cape. One of these days, I'm going to get you to roll a dark side character.
Oh, yeah, I'll probably end up doing one. I think that will be after I bought, like, a character unlock thing for a race.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
I think a Mira Lan Sith would be fun.
Yeah, I'm going to play. I think I'm going to do Power Trooper next.
Oh, let me test the chat real quick. Hold on. So I just realized I changed this layout a bit, and I want to make sure everything still works. Okay, it does.
Ooh, now I get to see how you have your UI, because this game has a lot of different choices, and I'm always curious to see how people do their buttons.
Mine is default. Because I'm an MMO baby.
See, mine's default, but also I have, like, side buttons, too. Because I have too many, like, nice utility, I think is my problem, is, like, my core rotation.
Oh, I have new mail.
Ooh.
My screen is black right now.
I forgot how to check that.
You have to find a mailbox in-game.
Well, no, like, to see if you have new mail. Oh, I see. It's next to your ping in the world.
Mm-hmm. I'm waiting for the game to load. There we go. I'm gonna go hunt. Oh, it's you.
Hey.
Your mount hasn't loaded, so you were just hovering in midair.
I mean, it's, the life of the galaxy's most sexy Jedi Sentinel.
Where is the mailbox on this planet? Is it downstairs?
Yes, there's one downstairs. All the nice stuff is downstairs.
Yeah, appears on mailbox.
What if I just never stop using the, like, Celebration 2019 flair next to my name? Like, even when we're playing this game in, like, 5 years, I'll just be like, yeah, Celebration 2019, that was the year.
Ah, so this is part of my storyline, this piece of mail.
Nice.
My dear student, my mind grows clearer by the day. Something about the shielding technique. Right, because I have gathered a number of materials to assist your training on Tython. My illness and your unique circumstances meant that they went unused. I send them now in hopes that they will be of use to you, Arkaizen. Remember, completing the trials marks a waypoint on your journey as a Jedi, not the end. And then they gave me 858 credits.
Nice. That's a one repair.
I should probably go do that, actually.
Have you really taken gear damage? Oh, let's party up.
Let's see. My game is being junky right now.
I gotcha.
Rendering at the same time as MMOing with my computer that already likes to catch on fire sometimes. What if I just, like, threw an SSD in here? Because you had that one temporarily for the story, but then she left.
Okay, character sheet. Companion. No? No, companion is not. What the hey?
My game is not responding. This is fun.
How do I summon Buddy? Oh, here we go.
Oh yeah, I forgot that I have a pet that I should summon.
Wait, what?
What? Yeah, so, like, my stuff's at, like, 80% durability.
Okay.
Or also, some of it is.
I have a non-story companion.
Who's this? Who's this robot? Is this... Oh, this is one of the Gree.
It is. If you... So push N, and it opens your, like, followers and contacts.
Yeah, there they are. Huh.
That's awesome.
This includes high-powered dusting capabilities, monitoring the crew's caloric intake, and a selection of aromas from across the galaxy.
Yeah, also, I still have access to Kira. She's just like, no, I'm good. Dismiss myself. Bye.
Bye.
Like, I can still, like, I could just pull her out, like, if I wanted to right now.
Where is my pets? Where is pets?
Oh, also you can repair at the speeder vendor. Let's see. Content. Activities, chapters, renown, mission. It's not companion in contact. Oh, actually, it's under your abilities. If you push P.
Ah, okay. I'll do that.
That's
in a second.
Also where your vehicles are.
I had a thought. So this person, I can repair in here.
Yeah. The speeder vendor has repair function.
Oh, that's only 162 credits. That's nothing. There's pets. I have an astromech droid.
How did I end up with two astromechs?
You had one already, I think, from being a
preferred
or whatever.
Yeah, that, I think that's also how I got my other mount. I feel like there's a flashpoint calling our name.
Yep, we gotta go to space.
We gotta. Oh, right, the hub station.
This person has a jetpack.
I like that a lot. I wonder how much that costs.
It was, I think, around 1,500 cartel coins.
Oh gosh, I don't have that much.
So many ways. This game is definitely chugging a bit for me.
Oh no.
Oh boy. It's because my computer is trying to do like three other things right now for no reason. I didn't tell it to do that, but it's like around this time every night, it's like, hey, maybe I want to try doing some stuff. And I'm like, please don't. Right, hi, Charlie.
Hi.
Oh, here's there's a flashpoint over here, actually. There's already someone down here.
Ooh.
This is the one we're looking for, Hammer Station. You're here just in time to watch us do a conversation, aka my favorite part of this game.
Legitimately, this is probably one of the best, this is probably one of my favorite ways to, like, handle cutscenes in an MMO.
We are interesting organics. What are people saying? Is that Bastila? No, it's Satil again.
All these white lady Jedi masters. Satil is really cool, though.
Serious emergency.
Jader is a very good name for a droid.
Right.
But yeah, so quick rundown of how that works is basically whenever we go into a conversation, we both get to choose options, dialogue options, but we roll to see who gets higher, like we were rolling for greed or something.
Yeah, it kind of treats it like a... we were rolling against each other, and I like how... One of the nice things is if you... Because some point or some conversation elements have like light or dark implications, and if you disagree with the rest of the party or just the other person you're with, it won't give you
the negative thing or the thing that you don't want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you pretty much, you still get that point that you would have gotten if yours was picked.
Mm-hmm.
Which can be really nice because there's certain pieces of gear that are like light side requirement X or dark side requirement X.
Yeah, like Crash's lightsaber that they wanted to use because it was red, but so they just took the crystal out.
Actually, it was strong, was the thing, too. Like, it was better than the offhand weapon I was using, because I'm dual-wielding. And it was, like, a legitimate upgrade, and it looked cool. So, it was, like, honestly the best of, or, like, everything you could ever want in an MMO.
I need to show off my lightsaber, because it's my favorite thing about my character right now, honestly.
Yeah, I just look like a fuckboy.
Yeah, like, for real.
For canon. It's so good. It's
like, yours is like a big himbo energy, to be honest.
Yeah. He's, well, there's a different body type that I could have done. I think that would have been like big himbo energy, but I'm like lithe and himbo.
Yeah. So this is my lightsaber, and I bought it off of the market because it has like a little, the tip on the end looks like a flamethrower tip, and instead of a button, it's got like a hand grip that you have to press in.
I also like that it kind of comes to a point like a longsword.
Yeah.
Like, I know a lot of lightsabers do that, but I feel like...
Actually, I think they all do in this game, because yours sort of do that as well.
Yeah. I just feel like it's extra noticeable for that color, maybe?
Yeah, I really like green lightsabers.
Honestly, like, if I wasn't... Like, I probably would have gone for double orange, because I do have the two crystals for it. But I just... I couldn't pass up... I don't know, bending canon and making nerds cry.
Our characters have, like... So I was thinking about this earlier. Because I was thinking about Obi-Wan Kenobi. And, like, our characters have sort of, like, that Clone Wars, like, tag team kind of... like energy, I feel.
Uh-huh. Oh gosh, somebody's just firing their laser guns. Okay. I feel like that's gonna make your stream chug when you get to it.
Oh it's just my game Tifa. Is extremely chugging right now. What can I do? Nothing. I'm gonna give my computer a second to get this shit together.
Yeah, this place is, like, congested, and that always will make things bothersome.
Mm-hmm. Also, like, my antivirus program is being a shithead right now.
Ugh. I'm glad the one I use is very, like, yeah, just leave me on one night a month, and I'll do all my scans... Just gotta remember to leave me on so I can do my thing after, like, operating hours. And then the time that I, like, accidentally stay up really late, it's like, what are you doing on? I need the computer. Get off, dude.
Yeah, but, I need to, like, swap mine out at some point. I haven't found the time to find a new one.
I just use Windows Defender.
Okay, I might just start doing that, honestly. I don't do enough illicit shit to warrant me having... Plus, I hear Windows Defender is actually pretty good these days.
Yeah, and, like, it just comes with 10. Like, if you...
I don't have 10.
I know, I'm saying... But, like, when you go to build your computer, and if you get Windows 10 for the OS, like, it'll come with Windows Defender.
Mm-hmm.
C2N2 is that style of healing class that I was talking about, where they throw a little, like, mech at you and, like, spins around you and sprays you with stuff.
Oh, nice.
It's very, like, gadget-based healing, which I think is really interesting for the fantasy.
Charlie, I mean, I'm sure it is actually buffering for you, for sure. Just also letting you know that my computer is doing a lot of that as well. Oh, man, someone's piloting the barge through the space center. And it was, like, drifting sideways. It was great.
Oh, my gosh.
My computer is at, like, 100% CPU usage right now.
No! I wish I knew... What is this station actually called?
This is the Republic
Carrick
Fleet.
Station.
Okay.
So this is a Fast and Furious Carrick Station Drift.
Okay, I made it over to you.
Yay! Sometimes I forget your character is just... named Elizabeth, but, like, spelled in a Star Wars way.
Yeah.
And like, my brain just kind of forgets that. Identities confirmed. All of you are listed. It's adult Yoda again. Opening holo channel to Republic
Fleet Admiral Jedi Master Ote. Stand by. I was just saying that it sounds like it is definitely on your end, but oh no, I hate this Yoda. Get this Yoda out of here.
Like, Baby Yoda's good, and Old Yoda is a war criminal, but I think this one's a war criminal too.
The situation can't be good.
Good and bad are relative. Let's just say the situation.
Get the fuck out of here with that sentence.
I don't like looking at his feet. Also, look how small he is. The close-up does not make him look that small. I'm gonna be mean to him now. You're itty bitty.
Okay.
And I'm a space elf.
Oh, yeah, no, sorry, I was, like I was saying before, it does sound like it's on your end. I was just letting you know my computer is not handling it well either. I don't like how upright they are. They, that's my problem with, like, middle-aged Yoda.
Yeah, yeah, and that and, like, every time we've seen, like, old Yoda, he has his feet obscured because he's a puppet.
Oh, he's got, makes sense. Sometimes he has three times he has four toes. It's weird.
Yeah. But it's just like, I don't know, there's just like, I just feel like the feet should just be left in mystery, or just put those feet pics on Patreon, like, I don't need to see that in my Star Wars.
Which one am I going to? Dropship Panger?
It's Dropship whichever Panger. One has the mission for.
It was, yeah, it was showing me two, because one of them is also for your story mission.
Yeah, yeah. We'll come back for that. Oh, I think one of them is also probably yours, too, considering you have to go.
I'm not sure.
Talk to your ship?
Yeah, I think I have to go to my ship or something. I don't know. Yeah, I have to use my ship's holo terminal. Terminal?
Terminal. Oh, sorry.
I took the wrong. Oh, no, you just got out of the exit earlier than me.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of us running around, I think. Oof. It's this one, right? Yeah.
Yeah, because the other one is for Mandalorian Raiders, which we are not at yet.
One day.
I pulled up a list, and it's like, here's everything you can do in this game in chronological order of story.
Okay, actually, this kombucha is pretty good. It's like super gross. Well, I liked it to start, but it's like really growing on me.
Never heard of this group. What do they have to? You beat me by one. I wanted to ask about why we had battle stations.
Oh, fair.
Hammer.
Hammer. I need a hammer.
That's. If we have an option to blow up Hammer Station, I want to blow it up.
Okay. Why do I get the feeling we're about to add battle station demolitionists to our resumes? I love Crash's voice. Oh, this is not picking mine. Not my way, Master. Destroying that station appears to be our best hope for peace. Force is strong in you. Let it guide you to victory. Destroying the station is your main objective, but we need to know how the hegemony obtained it. Any data you recover could prove useful. Hammer Station has just entered orbit above Semipalmy and demanded its surrender. Your assault shuttle is standing by. May the Force be with you.
Always.
And also with you. Oh, I didn't realize that was a zone trigger. Sorry.
It's okay. Additional character slots are available from the cartel market.
You also just get, like, four.
Yeah, you get four.
For being preferred.
I think I also just have four.
No, you get four more.
Oh.
Because I have eight. And I don't think I've
eight is all you need.
It really is. I mean, literally, it's like one of every. Well,
it's one of every class, which is technically every story.
Yeah, But it's not like that's also not doubling up, so you can't do like Sith Shadow and Sith Sorcerer.
Yeah.
Because they have the same base class.
I meant like one that's one for every story.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, this transport is a dumpster.
Oh yeah, no. I wanted to grill her and be like, this sounds like a one-way mission. Cause it like kinda really does.
Oh, we have a repair droid here.
Whoo, I don't like that. Yeah, when you wipe, there's a repair droid.
Border suppressor droid. That does not sound great. I love seeing 4-digit numbers come off of this robot.
Right?
This is strong.
I like actually being able to do my rotation instead of just like looking at something funny and it dying.
Hey, guess what? That was a level 70 droid.
Yeah, no, we're synced to 70 for this.
Oh, are we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's how they handle the story dungeons, like this.
I was trying to get used to where my buttons are again.
It's all good? Oh, look at the little tank around me! Ah!
Adorable.
This is the kind of healer that I want to play. I'm just gonna throw gadgets and gizmos at people and be like, have out. Let's see, can I hit both of them? Yes! Oh, I love this. I was worried that I wouldn't be able to hit both of them from, like, standing in the middle. Totally did. Ugh.
I haven't been able to pick up any of the loot. This feels weird.
What are we set to?
I mean, I got the loot. Like, it said, like, oh, I received credits and stuff. But, like...
Oh, yeah, it's just because I'm getting to it before you, I think. I will not be so trigger happy about that, so you can have some of that experience. Ooh, I love seeing damage absorbed. Ooh. Man. C2N2 is like putting in work.
What a fun little friend.
Yeah. Do you want to grab, like, hit this border suppressor and pull him back? So we're not fighting, like, him and, like, some other stuff?
I just barely missed it.
He was also moving.
Nope, I definitely got the rest of them too.
This will be a test. See how well the AI heals can do. You might need a spot heal.
Oh, yeah, hold on. What is it? Nope, we both died. Alright, well.
I think that would work if you set your companion to passive. Throw a spell and then walk it back and then throw him into go get him mode. Because he's tanking right now, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, so let me... Yeah, see, even just hitting him with, like,
okay,
a passive spell just triggered everyone, and I am exploding.
Okay, yeah, they're all linked together, but...
I'm going to die. This is hard.
It's on veteran.
Why are we on veteran? Not, as far as I know, neither of us have cleared this.
Well, we have two different options. I have veteran hammer station and story hammer station.
Yeah, I have that online too.
Let's exit, because we might be trying to do veteran at the moment. And
yeah, I think so.
How do we leave? Is it the transport to leave?
Yeah, it's not even letting me track regular.
And that's weird, because like I have on my character, I have it set to mission difficulty preference story, not veteran and not master.
Where is that at? So I can make sure that mine is also that.
Right click your portrait next to your abilities.
Yeah, mine's also set to story.
That's weird.
I forgot my belt glows. Spaceship Road, take me home.
Oh, next to the map, there's a little thing that says Hammer Station Expansion Excavation, and there's a little dealio that says Exit Area. Like, the mini-map in the lower right.
Yeah, I clicked it.
Okay.
Crunchyroll. Take me home.
Oh my gosh. Last night, while I was having some of the insomnias, YouTube was like, hey, I'm gonna send you some cursed shit to watch at 1 a.m. So one of the videos was Country Roads, Take Me Home, but it's in minor key.
Oh god. Is it not already in minor?
No, it's in major.
Huh.
It just has a couple of, like, it uses, like, the minor, like, sixth a couple of times. But it always, like, resolves into something happy. To have that, like, sense of progression and, like, you know, like, you're moving forward and all that kind of stuff.
There was a video that was kind of like that that I got sent by YouTube. I need to fucking look what it was. Because it was pretty wild. Let's see. Drowning pool bodies, but it's set to the Drake and Josh. That means it's the music of Drowning Pool, but with the lyrics from the Drake and Josh theme song.
Okay. I'm gonna tab out. Since you're the one doing the stream, I don't want you to have to, unless you could do it on your phone. I'm gonna do a Google for story mode Hammer Station.
Ah, Charlie just got the gift that I ordered from them that took forever to ship because it was from Latvia.
Okay, cute.
It is a package of Futari Wa Pretty Cure stickers.
Oh! Oh!
Oh?
Okay.
Did we go to the wrong level? Do we have to go to a different floor?
Hammer Station doesn't have a solo mode.
Uh-huh.
It is one of the few dungeons that does not have a solo mode. I think if we're going to clear it, we have to queue in with randos.
Gross.
Yeah. Let's see. The flashpoints that have solo mode are Essel's, which is our faction.
Wasn't Essel's the first one we did?
I think so. Barrel 5, or Terrell 5, I'm sorry. Maelstrom Prison, Directive 7, Battle of Ilum, The False Emperor. And I think this is all like expansion stuff. The False Emperor, Battle, or Assault on Tython, Korriban Incursion, Manon Research Facility, Legacy of the Rakata, Blood Hunt, and Battle of Rishi.
I know that Manon and Rakata or whatever are both from an expansion because it's like an entire expansion about KOTOR shit.
Yeah, no, I think there's like a point where they're just like listed as, both factions. And like, I feel like that's all expansion stuff. Dang, I was really looking forward to doing that too.
Yeah, that's a shame. Why? Why would they make the first one not be what like they would be from then on? You know?
I have no idea.
Hmm. Alright, well, I guess let me just abandon that quest or something.
Hey, though.
Okay.
We can queue for solo mode Maelstrom Prison.
Let me check where that is on the timeline.
Oh, okay. You know what? It's probably after and then our next planet. We're just level appropriate for it.
It's weird that the Flashpoint list that I found listed this as a level 15 one, then. If it's just putting us to 70.
It's level 15, but okay, so the idea is you can start doing it at 15, but because everybody's synced to 70, you can be paired with everybody from 15 to 70.
Oh.
And that makes it so the queues go faster and they fill up more quickly. Warcraft started doing that with they started being less strict with their dungeon levels, where they'd be like, it's like from 20 to 60 for dead mines, so you could get somebody from like anywhere in that gap and it gives you proportional experience and everyone's kind of like synced to a relative same amount of like stats, so you're not just steamrolling.
So, what was the name of that Flashpoint you were just talking about that we could do?
Maelstrom Prison.
What if I told you that that was 5 planets from now?
Yeah, it's on the solo activities list for us, and I just have this giant green button that says travel to it.
Like, we are literally 5 planets ahead of the level curve.
That's so funny.
Like, our next planet is supposed to cap out at 20.
Okay, yeah. And then another thing to note that's interesting, at least to me, under the group activities for the two of us, one, it won't let me specifically queue for Hammer Station, which stinks. Two, in that menu, it talks about syncing everybody. It says players below maximum level will be bolstered to the appropriate item level, and then it's also a role neutral mission, so you can be paired with like 4 DPS or like any sort of combination, and it should be clearable, which I think is interesting. But I'm also just like, if it's supposed to be role neutral, then like, why can't we do it with like the two of us and companions? That's not fair.
Oh, I found an even better timeline that randomly puts one of the level 55 flashpoints at level 20 area, because they're like, so this is weird because the dialogue changes on when you do it, because you can pick it up extra early, and until we get official word on where it's supposed to take place on the timeline, I'm putting it here. You know what, fuck it, let's just do Maelstrom Prison.
Let's just do it. No, okay. I'm just gonna hit travel. I don't know if that's gonna bring you with me.
I think last time you've done that, it asked if I wanted to go with you.
Yeah, I am party leader, so that should help. Okay, I'm pushing travel.
I did not do it.
Okay.
I think I'm already where I'm supposed to, already too close to where I'm supposed to be, so it won't let me. I can just get in the elevator and take it to where I'm supposed to go. It's fine.
Now, I wanna... oh, okay. So, on your mini-map, when you get into a place, There's a little tab that has like three little like generic people standing next to each other on the left side.
Mm-hmm.
If you click that, that's kind of the duty finder. And there's the, it has the solo tab, and that's how I got to Maelstrom Prison.
We are okay. Now I'm going.
And hopefully, because we're in the same party.
Advancing through social tiers grants you access to cosmetic gear. You actually, so if you win rolls in a conversation, you get points. And if you get enough points, you get new cosmetics.
Yeah, this questgiver is level 36.
Nice. About damn time. Finally, some good fucking food.
Great. Okay.
I want to try out the dogfighting stuff at some point.
Yeah.
I don't want to stream that because I don't think my computer will like it, but...
Wait, what?
So we're supposed to start our infiltration mission. I think he's like, oh, we won't start fighting without you. That's a different flashpoint.
Yeah, yeah, I'm curious that that one has a quest available for us, but this one does not.
Well, I think it's because we've already got it in our quest log.
Say that again?
Well, I think it doesn't have a quest available because we already have it in our quest log.
For Maelstrom Prison?
Yeah.
Do we?
It's on my top, it's in the top right on my screen.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I see it.
Activate combat support droid. I can talk today, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Group leader must reset the current flashpoint.
Group?
Reset all flashpoints.
Oh, I don't see that option. Do you have it? Oh, I see. Okay. Got it. We're good to go.
So I'm thinking about that that one edit of steamed hams, but to feel good ink.
Mm-hmm.
Delightfully devilish sea more. Steamed clams. Well, I tried to hit board, but it did not let me do the thing. That shuttle had some difficulty getting off the ground there.
Mmm. You really did.
Oh, I don't want to be one of those people that asks, like, hey, can I tell you a minor spoiler about Rise of Skywalker? But I kind of want to tell you about a minor spoiler of Rise of Skywalker.
You know, at this point...
It's literally in the first 5 seconds, and it's something that made my dad, like, so mad that he can't stop thinking about it.
Yeah, I haven't gone to see it at this point, so it's fine. I'm fine.
So, you know how every Star Wars movie starts with, like, space?
Uh-huh.
It doesn't. There's no, like, panning shot in space. There's no, like, spaceship coming in from off-screen. There's none of that. It just starts with, like, Kylo Ren walking around.
Sounds about right for J.J. Abrams.
It's also no, like, scene wipes, apparently. At least someone said that. I wasn't paying attention.
Oh. I don't know how I feel about that. Ooh. Ugh. I love it when the AI tank, like, does tank stuff. And then you push them all away.
Look, they pushed me. I had to push back. It's only fair.
I know, I know. It's only like my damage is proximity based. Okay, so you have to keep the combat support droid alive. This will be fun.
Defeat Imperial forces 10 out of 100.
You know, yeah, for a dungeon, that does feel about right. Hey, let's talk to
him. Oh, I want to take a look at this combat droid for a second.
So he's got a little bit of a built-in backpack. He's got, or they, it.
I love them.
No neck whatsoever. It's a, kind of looks like if Star Wars made a, what is that, a Zaku?
Yeah, it's got like a mono eye going on. It reminds me, like, the head shape in particular reminds me of Rex from Star Tours.
Mm-hmm.
Also known as DJ Rex, because he DJs in Galaxy's Edge now.
Nice.
Okay. Right. Let's activate the console.
With our swords.
We're hacking.
Sorry.
That maximum security droid is very big.
Hey, SWTOR, just let me be a droid, though.
They let us be a quote-unquote cyborg. It's barely a cyborg.
I know. Like, I get that there's, like, weird relations between, like, droid force users and, like, they may or may not even be canon anymore or whatever, but, like,
and whether or not droids have rights.
Yeah. Right? Little Miss Bastila lookalike, maybe just like, droids don't have rights. Get away from me. Oh my gosh. She's. Ow!
Look at this big motherfucker.
Not only did he slow me, but, or he punted me back, and then he put a movement speed debuff on me. So it was like insult to injury. Okay, I have a gap closer now. No!
Good job. No! Keezen was not having any of it.
Keezen. No! I feel like I'm really bad at maintaining one of my primary dots. Just not used to these icons. This is so much more manageable. Like, yeah, those like gold difficulty ones are like being a pain, but they're not like gonna kill us, you know?
Yeah. I'm not playing this game to have a challenge. I'm playing this game to have fun, please.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I know where to go if I want challenge from a game, an online game. This is not it.
No, I'm in here to have dumb Star Wars time with you, my friend.
Yeah. This is honestly my favorite kind of Star Wars, like, experiences. These kind of experiences you make with people you care about.
I had an idea for like a one-shot Star Wars thing, but I don't want to teach people the Fantasy Flight Star Wars system. I don't want to have to deal with that system again.
Very fair.
I want something a little bit more loose.
Yeah.
Like, it makes sense for something that's, like, post-Order 66, kind of. But I want to tell stories in that prequel era. That's, like, my whole shit.
What would be, like, my Star Wars persona for the prequel era? My original character was, like, from the Fantasy Flight system, was a former Rebellion pilot in the kind of, like, post episode 6 times. No! No! When do I get 2 charges on my gap closer? Like, there's a little number next to my, like, little jump at the enemy skill, and it currently it's sitting at 1, which makes me think that later it'll upgrade to more than 1. Reinforcements. Come on, Keezan. Drag the Overseer over to these other dudes.
I also really want to do, like, a very big pseudo LAN party thing with Star Wars Battlefront 2 Classic. Like, I can host my own server now. Oh. Keezan, why?
Right on you. The clothy.
Am I not? Oh, I'm trying to use a skill that I don't have off of cooldown. I was wondering why it wasn't working.
Those pesky cooldowns.
So many of my skills in this game don't have cooldowns.
Yeah.
Or they have such cooldowns that after I use one other move, it doesn't. It's done.
Yeah, that's what I like about. Oh, look at that oppressor. Oh, that's a boss. Okay, let's clear the room.
Oh, that's big. What?
Boss time! Yeah, you don't want to pull that kind of enemy and have him, like, kick you into these ads back here. That would be very scary. That's what I like about, like, classes like Sentinel, like what I'm playing, is a lot of the skills have short cooldowns, but they do, like, more damage than, let's say, things that wouldn't have a cooldown. So you have, like, you know, a couple of, like, whack-a-moles that have higher priority than the rest of the moles. But for the most part, it's just spending, 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 and building, building, building resources. Honestly, like, yeah, like, I think this is, like, the closest thing to, Oh, that's light armor. That's for you.
I'm probably not going to wear it because it looks dumb.
Fair enough.
It looks, it's that same kind of hat that we were talking about last time.
What's
this?
Oh, it's a heal terminal.
Oh, good.
Got a cute little heal over time. Be ready?
Yep. Oh, here we are.
Ooh. Somebody's stuck. Ooh. Ow. not a big fan of all that, like, explosion and fire stuff it's doing to attack me.
Yeah, it is definitely exploding a lot. We did it. We completed the droid.
We oppressed the oppressor. Hey, the support droid lived through that too.
Okay, mysterious voice.
Jedi entity.
Mood.
Love to learn who that is in five worlds. Gosh, I'm just like, feel like by the time we finish world five, we'll be level cap.
Honestly, yeah. That's like, I swear we must have broken something somewhere.
I mean, I will say we both don't have EXP buff up currently, and maybe that's fine for the moment.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have it up now, but I'm also still already almost gained half a level.
Yeah, no. Almost same. Combat support droid. Why are you picking fights by yourself? I like these kind of like back-to-back-to-back pulls. This feels very like cinematic and Star Warsy.
Yeah.
That, and since, you know, you're doing spot heals and we have healing, like my companion's healing, like...
Hey, let me let you in on a secret. I haven't hit a single fucking heal button since we came in here.
Honestly?
I basically haven't hit a heal button the entire time we've played this game. When I had to figure out when to press a heal button when we started that veteran thing, I was like, oh no.
Right.
Oh, there's a lot of Sith in here all of a sudden.
Yeah.
I'm just going to keep spamming my AoE attack.
Because
that move has zero cooldown.
I'm going to focus on this Overseer because I feel like he has heal. That's it. Yep. At the, what was it? Qatar Station? We can respec you if you want, so you can go, like, an actual DPS class.
I don't know. I mean, I feel you will probably need me to heal at some point. But also, like, because we have companions that can heal.
Yeah.
Because, like, even before you had this robot, T7 did healing stuff.
Yeah. I'm just... Like, if we... I think... I feel like the companions, like...
Maybe I should respec.
If I remember correctly, it's free. The only inconvenient thing is you have to go to the station to do it. And you can't, like, go to, like, the other class branch. So, like, you can't go to the double-ended lightsaber class. Because that's, like, a completely different branch altogether. Just, like, I can't go to the Jedi melee branch that has the tank. Like, that's just completely off-limits to me.
Oh, whoops. Alright, let's kill this thing.
But yeah, as far as I can tell, like, you can respec as much as you want. It's just, you have to leave the planet to do it, which can make it a little bit inconvenient. Have we done, like, any cutscenes since we got here?
Not really. There's a lot of stuff to blow up in this room.
Okay.
I'm not mad at that. And there's like a warden who's like menacingly sitting in the middle of the room.
Oh. As you do.
I'll wait till you guys come over here.
Yeah.
We're almost done. Strong. The warden is labeled. Oh my gosh. I need to start using that more. I have a cooldown that comes up every minute that lets me essentially pacify a target. They'll still attack, but they become like way less accurate.
Wow.
And it applies to their melee and ranged accuracy, which could be really handy. Oh, also I have force stasis. Should try using that. Oh, sorry. Ooh. I think I just pulled a boss.
Oh. It's probably fine. This is just a big man.
Ow, ow.
Never mind, I finally did some healing. I healed my companion a bit.
Yeah, he's like tearing up Kizan. This is wild. Oh no, the support droid! Oh! Optical implants? I found out. Maybe he'll be easier to kill now. Mechanics, you know, like a dungeon would have, like a boss in a dungeon.
Oh, like a boss in a dungeon.
Sounds fake.
Oh no, I got grabbed.
Yeah, he grabbed and shocked the whole team.
beat shit.
I'm gonna greet both of them.
Mm-hmm. Aha, I got the stabilizer. You got the bag of mats, it looks like.
Nice.
I'm glad we kicked that thing in stereo.
There's
a lot of healing stations in that section. We probably could have hit one of those during the middle of the fight.
It's funny because like my brain doesn't even reach for that. I just reach for I just want to punch harder to get the fight over with.
Oh, I think we are getting our first cutscene. Didn't we kill this guy before?
I think we just, like, pissed him off. Malgus.
Who?
Should your master's name mean anything to me?
Jesus! This is my first time picking a dark side option.
Your sacrifice won't be in vain. Take those Imperial ships with you.
Oh, and we agreed with each other too.
Eat shit and die, Oteg.
Give me just a moment. Shannon says something nice to my retweet about "We were live."
Oh, good. That's nice.
So I wanted to say something back. It's so she said I look like that one like gentleman.
I looked at it.
Yeah. And I'm just like, that's like literally what I told her when I commissioned her to draw my Hrothgar. That was like my reference. I was like, I want him to have that expression.
Aw. Let's look at the spaceships outside.
I love their like the trajectory that some of the lasers are going in. The vector that they're traveling in, the actual like rays coming out of the Star Destroyers don't, they're not like going along the vector, they're like off kilter a little bit.
Yeah, they're like sliding across space.
It's good.
Yeah. It just makes me want to play Battlefront too. I loved doing the space missions.
Aww.
Even if they didn't make sense to a child me. Oh, we're going to a place called the Sith Asylum.
Love that for us.
Oh, that's spooky. Hey, it's Big Man. Oh, I'm dying.
Oh,
Nope. I died.
Oh no!
Okay, I'm gonna run back. Oh, okay. I actually spawned right in that room before we went in the elevator.
This time we'll go down the elevator together.
Yes. Oh, at least one of them is still dead. The big one is still dead.
Nice.
Stage 2, defeat the unleashed beasts. I love episode 2.
I don't like how packed these hallways are.
Yeah, a lot of friends. A lot of friends to meet and show the end of my blade.
Thank you. Oh, it's because there's two overseers. Terminal.
Prison break. Ooh.
Is this the unleashed beasts?
Yeah, and a person with a purple lightsaber. A Sith Tormentor.
They're labeled as a maniac? I love that for them. Ooh, I'm like...
Go away. I don't want any friends back here.
I think they put a horror effect on me.
That one's big.
And there's two purple lightsaber friends.
Well, this is going to be a challenge.
We got it, though. Just use your cooldowns.
Oh, no. Go away. No, my pushing did nothing.
I have one of the tormentors back here. Oh.
Yeah, sorry. It was just the very, very big one was chasing me.
No, it's fine. They're actually all behaving and stacking all nice on each other, and now they want to punch you. Okay, focus down. No, I hate this stun. How dare the enemies in this game use crowd control when I know I can use crowd control too. Level 34?
Nice.
I feel like you're like...
I'm about to hit level 33.
Yes, you're very close behind.
unleashed beasts.
Unleash the beast.
I know this is supposed to be like a crate that the beasts were in, but from a distance I was like, that's a weird looking bed.
What is a crate if not a bed?
It's just like a really mean bed.
Yeah. It's a bed with teeth.
God.
Oh, one of these is green. Let me go touch the green one. Hello, friend.
We got company. What are the, like, mean flying monsters in Morrowind called?
You are asking the wrong person.
Are they, like, cliff divers?
Maybe.
That's what they remind me of, I guess is what I'm trying to say. They're like weird, not quite pterodactyls. Also, I just want to jump down like really bad. I know that's like certain death.
Yeah.
But I just
oh no!
Oh!
Well, it is. I had moved my camera around and then I hit forward and it put me forward. Hey, guess where I am?
Are you at the bottom?
I'm upstairs.
It's a good thing we cleared a path, huh?
I hope we did. Yeah, okay. Let me sprint. Wait. Okay, I cannot mount here. I had to check. Defeated by Reigns with fall damage, zero damage. love it.
Oh, while you're running, I can do a Google flying monster Morrowind. Cliff Racer. It was Cliff something. So what's happening is every time we start a pull, these tormentors open with like an AoE like horror stun. And that's hitting me and your companion. So
which
your
means, yeah, they
your
just
companion's start... not establishing aggro, and everything just beelines for you.
Gotta love it.
It makes for an interesting pull. Like it's, you know, you don't want everything to just be tank and spank all the time. Also, congratulations.
Hooray! See, that's what a level up should look like.
Right. You don't want everything just to be like, you know, just like nice and easy for your players. You want like some kind of interest, even if it's stunning your tank and beelining for your healer.
I love how we just kick it and then it explodes.
I also like that I can just, like, start kicking it after you've already started kicking it. Just to be like, yeah, me too. Good. Thump.
Now I'm thinking about the tweet I saw that someone made of, like, the edit of the scene from Revenge of the Sith, but Obi-Wan and Anakin are talking about headphones.
Oh. Of course Anakin would have AirPods.
Look out, you're turning to the dark side of the Force. Oh no, he has AirPods in. He can't hear us.
Hey, that was all the consoles. Also, it just occurred to me that I think these little dudes are not... Well, not little, but... they're supposed to be, like, a reference to the Tarrasque.
I think there's one of these in KOTOR. I recognize the name.
I mean, that's also probably a reference to the Tarrasque.
Probably. That entire game is just D20. This is very un-action music that's playing right now.
Yeah.
It's like a funeral dirge.
It's like the music that plays when Leia's like in her cell getting rescued by Luke, but before things like really pop off and like get crazy.
This guy's name is Lord Crankus. It's not, but that's what I read it as immediately. Up until said that out loud.
We have a healing stations up in melee range. I'll try to pop some of things get absolutely wild.
Alright, I'll try to get some of these ads out of the way.
Much appreciated. I can at least put a burn on the ones that get close to me. Can you have any, like, sassy dialogue for us?
Yeah, we don't know who any of these boss fights that we've been having are. This is kind of weird.
Oh, click a thing. Oh, he's a Sith Beastmaster. Oh.
That would explain all of the dogs.
Just like Tamlin. But he's not a Sith. But, like, I don't know, maybe.
Could be.
Maybe that's. Yeah. They're not quite space wolves, or else I was going to make a joke about Dave Filoni would be happy we're playing with wolves.
No, these are explicitly hounds.
Yeah. Ooh, is that blue quality gear light?
Yeah.
Let's go. Oh, I just got it.
Yeah, you got something. I got an encrypted transmitter.
But this is your kind of gear. I don't use foci.
It's weird.
No! Okay, I can mail that to you, actually.
I got military gear that I can give as a gift to my friend.
Mm-hmm.
Which I probably will, because I can't wait to have another conversation with a companion.
Thank you, Jackie. Love you, too.
Hi, Jackie.
Thanks for stopping by.
I should try to get people to do a Jackbox stream again.
I am definitely more in the mood for a Jackbox night than I was for New Year's.
New Year's had a fun energy afterwards.
I don't want to be that person that's like, I'm kind of glad that our plans fell through, but also, like, I needed that.
Like, yeah, our plans just became, let's all sit in a Skype call and talk and drink and catch up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And sometimes you just need that.
Yeah.
It's also like when you go to a diner and just sit there for like 3 hours.
Yeah. I don't know. I just like, it was nice for me to just be like, just be in the presence of like trans folk that, like, I am comfortable around for, like, an evening, and just, like, be able to just know that, like, you know, no matter where the conversation went, like, it was always gonna be, like, chill and safe.
Yeah.
Oh, we're doing consoles now. Okay. Got a hidden console behind here? No, dang. I know in the older version of SWTOR. Oh, they're indicated on the map.
Yeah.
Very smart and good at video games. In the older version of KOTOR, there, or not KOTOR, SWTOR, there was like holocrons you could find that were like
that's
away.
Still a thing, because I follow a SWTOR Twitter account and people are constantly tweeting about art. Today I saw multiple tweets about people going on Datacron for holocron hunts.
And like I think why I was like referring to them in the past is I think before they gave you like permanent stat changes, and I think they removed that aspect. But they're like in really like fun, like nooks and crannies of the universe, which I think is a neat way to do that.
The light side grows stronger.
But yeah, because we're the only people in here. Well, in our instance as well. Maybe we're the only people running a Maelstrom Prism story. Whatever I play next, I just want ranged damage capabilities.
I gotta say, they're pretty good to have.
I mean, that's my preference. That's what I usually go with.
I probably could stand on this red stuff, but I'm not gonna risk it.
I'm gonna do it. Woo! Can I hit this terminal without being attacked? Yeah, actually. I'm in combat because you're in combat. Love that. Solidarity. Thank you, Charlie. Have a good night. Love you, too. Sorry that the stream is being a butt for you, but thanks for sticking out as much as you could.
I'll definitely be putting up a VOD later, because it's just so easy. Yeah. Oh, I love how the laser became floor.
Oh!
Oh, I don't like how the laser became floor. It's big! It's as big as my AoE circle.
I can't even fit, like, the top of it.
Gotta look...
We gotta be, like... finishing up, right?
Yeah, we're getting pretty close. We got one more munition stockpile. This is the final stage of the bonus.
Yeah, this is just like...
This is an optional boss.
Oh!
I'm assuming, because this is part of the bonus objective when we hit all the terminals that did the containment stuff.
So when we do our GDQ run of SWTOR flashpoints... We will not be doing this.
No.
Ow, that looked like it really got you bad.
Yeah, I hit my self-heal.
My medium armor soaked a lot of that, actually, which was nice.
Oh, that killed me.
It is only at 70% health. What the hell?
Good luck.
I have no self heals. I just have.
Good lord. I kind of dig this though. It's nice to have the one like bit of challenge, I guess.
Yeah. Can you respawn, or is it just?
I can't. I can't respawn until the boss encounter is over. He's in even over there still?
No, he dismissed himself with you.
Ack.
Oh my gosh, that wasn't even what I wanted to click.
Can't believe it killed me from half health. That was amazing.
Oh, me too.
That literally stomped on top of you. Alright, let's start the run back. Let's run it back.
Yeah.
We've got
just
this.
Trying to figure.
I was actually, right before it killed me, I was considering turning around and hitting the health station.
Damn. Yeah.
So I kind of dig how the background for the stream came out, because I just color corrected the Sequinox background that I made.
Yeah. I like it too.
It made the constellations pop in like a bright green for some reason.
I really want to get a nice layout for like streaming Final Fantasy 14 stuff.
I feel like I need to make a stream mascot.
Mm-hmm.
Just like a little character or something to put on the bottom little bar, because I feel like I need to have the bottom bar there, because if I have the chat on the side, scaling the screen just makes it small.
Mm-hmm.
And like Battle Network, my layout on that is fun because I put the characters on it.
Yeah. Oh, also I think I found Munition Stockpile 12.
Oh. Nice. Did not realize that was considered a bonus objective.
Yeah, technically our next objective is just to enter the core chamber. We could just ignore the ancient maelstrom flare.
I want to fight the big thing again. I want to give it at least one more shot.
I think that is absolutely fair.
It's so big. Hold on. There we go.
Oh, we lost our combat support droid. And it won't let me...
You must be in a solo flashpoint to use this item.
We had it to start with.
Gross. I mean, I get it. I guess if you're doing this solo, they want you to have backup.
Mm-hmm. And we are each other's backup.
All right,
Do you have a stim or a med pack on your hot farm?
I don't think I have med packs.
Dang.
I just kept selling them because I didn't use them.
Fair enough. Honestly, I kept them because I hoard everything.
Let me set my companion to attack so he gets the opening shot, I guess.
Okay.
Okay, I need to go hit a healing thing.
I'll grab the next one. There's one next to me on the wall.
I just had to grab that one because that takes me to so low health.
Mmm.
Like, if he does it again right now, I will die. Yep, there I go.
How many times can I click the terminal before it's just like, I am out of Bacta, leave me alone. Ow!
Big boy, tough.
Oh no!
What happened?
It punted me into the geometry.
Oh no!
I am behind a crate.
And it fully re-healed itself.
Yeah, because it can't hit me, I can't hit it, and it's a protocol. I'm just got to use. Shit. Slash stuff.
Alright, we're gonna have to run past this thing. Hey, guess what?
Hey.
You know all that gear that I just repaired?
Yeah.
57% durability.
What will happen if I do slash stuff?
It will kill you. Because that's what we had to do when we had the bug with the in combat thing.
Oh! It just moved me on the other side of that crate.
Oh, cool. Maybe because it knew what to do in that situation.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm looking over here first. And do some quiet munching into the microphone.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we gave the big thing our best.
Yeah. It makes me a little sad because one of my MMO friends is back in college. Well, I'm not sad that he's back in college, but. He's been very busy with taking school seriously.
Mm-hmm.
So he's not like checking a lot of our group chats as frequently anymore. If he was, I could just be like, hey, can you carry us through this optional boss in the flashbook? Because he has, oh wait, no, I think his main is on the other faction. Because I think he has an operative, which is the Sith equivalent of the scoundrel.
Well, let's just give us another reason to run it again when we get to actually this point in the story.
Yeah.
I'm gonna fight that Mario again someday.
Alright.
Do.
Bye, friend!
Hold on. Wait. Ooh. Give me 1 second.
Oh, we're gonna wave goodbye to it?
Oh, and time for another boss.
Probably one that's like actually not crazy though.
Oh, the Emperor. about how much Imperial style propaganda and stuff seems to be in this game, a game that's set before the like New Republic or whatever.
Right. I think like one way to think about it is it's kind of one of those like, you know, the like shitty fascists are always shitty and like,
yeah, like, it's just like
never changes.
They even use the same like symbols is the thing.
Yeah. I feel like the boss is dying so much faster than his minion.
Yeah, that minion is like taking a lot of damage, I've noticed.
I'm just not gonna punch it unless I'm like, is he disappearing or is he just...
He's disappearing and then he reappears to choke me. But only me for some reason.
You know, it might be one of those cases where he's like set to like say like fuck whoever's healing, and
your droid has done more healing than I, for sure.
But you are cued in on the healer role. The game recognizes you as the healer.
Yeah.
So it's gonna do different things to you than it would to me.
Blue time.
I got a belt.
I also got a belt. A much better belt. Plus 10% force sensitivity.
Oh wait, no, I saw your belt in the in the list. I got gloves.
Oh, well, gloves are good.
Yeah. Oh, and it's adaptive armor too. Which means it gives you as much armor as whatever like you wear, so like you don't have to worry about like, oh well, we got heavy armor, neither of us wear heavy armor, that sucks.
Oh, someone just came in on a jetpack.
This is the fleet, one of the fleet troopers?
Yeah, all of the 5th fleet troopers that are like on the side over here all just came flying in on jetpacks. And I just threw one of them off of the side. That was great. I love that.
Oh my gosh. Can we just like... Oh, damn, no. I was about to ask, can we just like avoid pulling that maximum security droid?
That's fine. I got rid of it.
I'm glad one of us is playing an actual magic class.
I'm so glad that it was standing up on the railing and I could, in fact, push it.
See, and I'm also glad that this game is coded in a way that is possible instead of what would happen in, like, Warcraft or Final Fantasy XIV, which is it would bug out as soon as you pushed it and would be like, no, I'm just gonna go back to my home point and just like respawn. Like, I'm glad that is supported by like the game's engine to have like those very Star Warsy kind of moments.
It's very good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's over here shit talking about the guy we already killed. That's good. You gotta love when that happens.
Right. I just really love incompetent bureaucratic Sith. Like, I think that's one of the reasons why I like playing that faction, is just because they're just like, they're just so bad at their job. Ooh. Ow. Ow.
Oh. Oh. I was not low on health, was I?
You dropped, though. You dropped really quickly.
Yikes. I love spawning upstairs every time.
It's all good?
We have to go say hi to Big Mario again.
I wonder how many people are live on Twitch right now streaming SWTOR.
I mean, based on the fact, like, based on who gets retweeted by the Star Wars The Old Republic Twitter account, I mean, there are some people who very consistently stream it.
Yeah, I'm just like, I'm curious about the metrics.
Yeah. I actually have all of my metrics right now covered up by my OBS window.
And we... Oh, it's not this room.
We've been doing this flashpoint for like an hour and a half.
Yeah, I think that's one of the things I like about, even though you have to play with randos, doing four-person flashpoints does not take this long because you have four people contributing DPS. You don't have companions in the mix, but I think players...
When do
I would wager to say players?
Yeah, they probably have better like abilities and stuff for it, and you know you can actually swap out their gear for that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
At what player count did they get rid of your companions? Is it at three?
I think so.
So I think that's how Monster Hunter does it. Do 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 do. This is my favorite part of the movie, where it's just like 5 uninterrupted minutes of the Jedi running through an empty spaceship.
Special Star Wars remix of running through the 90s.
There's an entire like Star Wars remix album that I could be playing right now.
Alright. Let's do this one more time. Shall we? One of them down.
Yeah. Oh, they dropped a green.
Love that for us, because that's going to be good gear. Also me standing right next to a terminal.
I got a humanoid skull.
Forget where Kazakh stands on humanoid skulls if he likes them or not.
Alright.
Oh, this is perfect.
Oh, it's music to my ears.
Oh, that was beautiful. Oh, this is what it's like to be a Star Wars.
That's what I want from Star Wars.
Well, let me recommend Star Wars The Force Unleashed. Someone just threw Keezan off the map. I was like, why did I looked over, I saw something go fly. I'm like, oh, it must not have been anything. And then I suddenly got the tooltip, hey, Keezan died.
Yeah. I mean, oh god. Okay. Notice how I have the droid turned away from the edge. It's how you know that I'm a tank main, because I think about stuff like that. So I don't want to get pushed over the edge, but I would love for him to be pushed.
Good recovery.
Do you have Revive Companion on your bar?
I do not. I just hit the powers button. I don't even see a revive companion thing in my list of things. Ah, here we are. Out of range. Move closer. Uh-oh.
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Join him and over the edge.
Well, bye, Keezan.
Yeah, you might need to dismiss him and resummon.
What is that under? There it is.
Yeah,
found it.
Yeah, you should be able to right-click his portrait.
Oh, thank you. I accidentally hit my heal button. It's fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm healing myself over time now.
Love that for you.
This is a big room.
Oh, there's a lot of scary security droids. So we're gonna have to fight two of these at the same time.
Okay. Ugh. I just got an achievement for having money.
Oh, thank you, Keezan. Oh my gosh. Ugh. I love our AI take so much. They're like, Crash's leap is not up. I should pull the boss to Crash. And me, I guess.
Love to just pull people around with my cool rope, says Kizen. Alright, well, let's...
Sorry. Were you trying to menu?
No, I just noticed that, like, suddenly all of the names popped up in the middle there before the people actually showed up. And I was like, oh, that's a lot of names to just suddenly show up.
That's one of my favorite strategies for when you're playing a melee class. You're like, I want to dash to this target, but I'm like a smidge too close. So you just like backpedal a little bit and then you can just gap close to them.
I have 100,000 credits.
Same. Love to talk to a door.
Hey door, how's it going?
Oh gosh.
Uh-oh.
I have an Imperial Sniper. He's my third highest character.
It's a green door, all right. I was expecting him to have a deeper voice.
There's no time like the present, my lord. I'll accomplish both objectives.
You abandon calculated tactics for irrational revenge. This won't end well.
By all means, assist in your overconfidence.
The Empire submits you, Grand Moff Killerat. I leave you to reclaim your honor.
I wish we were closer to the edge.
Yeah.
Just imagining, like, as soon as the fight starts, hitting that button and instantly killing him.
Let's DPS the... Good. Let's get the bodyguards down and then try to group up the troopers. This hurts. They're making us drink the bone hurt juice.
Alright, I've given you a heal over time.
Definitely,
or as they say, a hot.
They do say that. I have said that. I have been known to talk about hots. Okay. Point of comparison. That optional mini-boss we fought had 100,000 HP. Mr. Grand Moff Killrin only has 40,000.
He also had like 7 goons, but also
yeah.
The goons were easy to deal with.
Yeah, they really weren't that bad. It was just we had to take the time to DPS them down. Oh, let me touch a terminal.
Oh yeah, I'm also getting low.
Did that reach you back there? Okay.
Yeah.
It did.
Where'd he go?
He jumped away. Oh, he's around the corner.
Oh, this means there's gonna be more goons.
Or maybe he's just like trying to just snipe us. No, we're definitely gonna get ambush.
Oh yeah, here's some dudes.
I'm gonna come help you with that after I get this trooper down.
I got them. They're probably fine. I'll just hit them with my AoE a few times.
This one's not in your range. Watch your HP.
Oh, yeah. Good call.
Ow.
Oh no.
It's all good. There's terminals by him if you... Oh.
Well, time to run through all of that area again.
Jeepers.
Oh, wait. Actually, we're closer than normal.
Yeah,
so.
We're way closer. Okay. I'll, hit the switch faster this time. Because there's like, two terminals in melee range on that phase.
I could have gotten rid of those troopers a lot faster if I hadn't accidentally hit my four earlier.
Gotcha. Wait, he's just, like, at the end of the hallway.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of being, like... Because he was, on like, way on the other side before.
No, he was at the end of this, and when we got up to him, that's when he did the thing. Oh, wait, no, he's much closer this time. What the hell?
Yeah. I won't tell Sorter if you don't tell Sorter.
They put him in, like, his cutscene position.
Okay, yeah, okay. I'm gonna touch a terminal on the way. Get us topped off. Here's the ads. Okay, yeah. Looks like we just got some cute little chip damage on him before this whole shenanigans. Ow!
Yikes. What the hell?
I think our companions just like beelined for him.
Yeah, no, he's indefinitely dead.
Super helpful, dude.
I took 2,500 damage.
Yes.
That's half of my health. Okay, well, that was bad.
Right. Also, I like how before everything, as things were all going to hell, that's when I saw another terminal to hit. I'm like literally turning my back.
Well, just think about how... Oh, he's all the way back in his original position this time.
Where he's supposed to be, okay.
Just think about how we won't need to replace some of our gear in, for like another few planets after this.
Definitely. Come over here, bodyguard.
Oh, I'm already almost dead. What the hell?
Yeah.
Why was my spell not going off? What the fuck? How did we die so instantly on this one?
I don't know. I feel like your companions are fucking up. Because, like, I didn't even see Keezin with us. I saw C2 with us, but... So weird.
Let me specifically tell him to attack one of these front enemies.
Yeah. Alright. Let's do it. My honor will be
satisfied. Hey, Keezin? Where the fuck are you, dude? Hey. Keezin's still back here doing literally nothing.
Yeah, no, mine did the same thing.
Huh. What the fuck?
Okay.
It's like
despawn.
It's like this door is a barrier that they won't go past.
Right.
Like, I literally just tested it. Hold on. Let me dismiss and resummon.
Mmm.
Yeah, he's still not going.
Yeah, I dismissed, walked through the barrier, and then resummoned, and now he's working.
Well, it's gonna suck if we have to do that again after this. Oh, good lord. Okay, phew.
C2, come back here. He just like fully overextends himself. I'm just like, yeah. Keezan's doing the same thing. He's just like, yeah, let me just go run up to the boss.
To be fair, it would be better for the boss to be attacking them than us at this point.
Yeah, absolutely, but also I want C2 to heal me. Why am I doing zero damage to him?
Yeah, why is he invincible? The fuck?
Can you walk up to him or push him?
No. He did not. He's also not damaging me.
Oh, he's fucking me up. Okay, so his dumb little scream increases ranged tech and force defense by 100. He cannot be interrupted, and he can detect stealth. So my lightsabers don't do anything to him because he's just force proof.
Why is he? Why? How long does the scream last?
We didn't have to deal with it last time.
I feel like it's been a minute.
He's taking chip. Okay. Yeah, I'm doing damage now. He was just like at like 50%. Or no, he was at 100%, like not even like budging. And now he's like actually taking damage. Ow. Yeah, now he's like standing up and he doesn't have his little shield in front of him. Alright. We are topped off.
Alright, things are going much better.
Okay, so he's got two terminals for healing flanking him up here.
Alright.
Are there any back there where you are?
Looks like there's going to be some here in a second. Or, sorry, hold on.
The healing terminals.
Yes. Yeah. Let me check.
I'm gonna pop one.
Why am I targeting him still?
Okay, I'm gonna come help with these troopers. Oh. Holy shit. Okay. Why do I have Argo? We got it!
Oh, okay. My game almost crashed. I just suddenly I heard like. Oh, I got a pair of gloves.
I got an implant. That was tough.
Yeah, this door is locked.
What do we do next? Oh, this term, this right here, huh?
Oh.
Giant.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Shall we, together?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it. Oh, okay. That's where our prisoner was.
Oh, it's still loading for me. There we go. Who's this dude?
Where?
Oh, what?
No. Done. There's nothing to restrain him now. I fought half the Empire to free you. Is this how you say thanks?
I feel like we can be mean to him.
Who sent you?
Your strength fails.
Is the fucking Jedi entity Kreia? I'm gonna be pissed if it is.
You should be one with the Force. Finally at peace.
More peace while you suffer. The Emperor drowns you.
No. Does this guy have a new face stapled onto his face?
That's what it looks like.
That's some fucking handsome Jack shit.
It really is.
Betrayed from within. The Emperor imprisoned me, kept me alive with Sith alchemy. Use me.
One of your allies stabbed you in the back? I assume they paid for that.
He still lives by the same dark forces I do. Serving as the Emperor's executioner, his undying wrath. The Emperor used me as his link to the light side of the Force, the Jedi Order. Through me, he saw visions. But that same link also gave me influence. I convinced the Emperor peace was in his best interest, tempered his hate.
The peace is lost. The Emperor makes his final rule.
Get the fuck out of here.
You know, for what started as a very story light dungeon,
it just like suddenly fucking went there, right?
I'm shook. New codex entry, Revan.
I got a new stronghold decoration.
Oh yeah. Oh wow.
Whoa, that's two levels. That's two levels that I just gained. Wowie, wow, wow, wow.
Right? I think that locked door should be unlocked now.
Yeah, I've almost reached social level two.
I am... social or legacy?
Social is what I was talking about. My legacy is level 2.
Okay. Mine's 3. Oh my gosh, how do we leave?
This way. Into the orange. I can't fucking believe that shit.
What a... What?
What an exciting thing to learn about in 5 planets.
Oh. Okay.
I'm glad to know that my immediate reaction to hear anyone saying Revan is get the fuck out of here.
I also like that we both agreed on being a little bit mean to him.
That was fun.
That turned around. At first I was like, this is a little bit of a slog, not gonna lie.
Yeah, it's kind of, it was like, I wanted a little bit more throughout instead of having just like some story right at the end.
Yeah, I think they were trying to be like, ooh, mysterious Jedi entity talking to you as you go, but like, now I see what
I would have liked to see, like a cutscene where that happened instead of it just happening while we were walking.
Yeah, because honestly, like, if I had music on the whole time, I would have probably not. I probably would have missed some of that. All right, sorry, I need to spend a skill point.
Yeah, I probably need to also. Or no, I don't.
You'll get one at 35. That's why I'm spending it. What is the spell rebuke? Which one are you? Do I not have it? Oh, there it is. Okay.
Why is the Maelstrom Prison thing still in my quest list? Let me take it out of there. Okay, that was a fucking experience.
Right?
It's just like right at the end, too. Fuck. What? Okay. I'm gonna go to like the main group area. Just walk around for a bit.
Yeah.
Looks like you still have the hammer station in your quest list, by the way.
I do. Oh, huh. Yeah, I still have the
How do I...
Oh!
But how do I get back to Tokyo?
Oh, gosh.
I teleported to Interfleet Transport.
Mm-hmm. That's the one that I just went to. That seems to be the correct one. Maybe? No.
Yeah. No, the one that I went to, you can go to Carrick Station from here. Which is where we're trying to go. I'll wait till you arrive before I... Yeah. You go left, and it should take us to Carrick Station.
There it is. Ooh, this is fun.
Right. Oh, wow. Gosh, I just got goosebumps, because it's like it feels so high up.
I like the look of the shuttle, too.
Yeah. Okay.
Comes in very hot, though. Should have slowed down a little bit more. I don't think that droid should have a run animation like that.
Oh yeah, I'm watching my droid like skip on your screen.
Just in general though, having like a real ass run animation when it's definitely a protocol droid.
Right. Oh right, it's time for your game to die a little.
That's actually fine. I think it was literally just because my computer was doing some shit. Hey, do you want to do the prelude to Shadow of Raven?
Oh my gosh, some twinky looking human boy in a space harness named Starkillar.
Oh, incredible.
Why are you on the Republic side though?
Because he was a good guy in the end. Let me tell you about Star Wars The Force Unleashed. And the Jedi Master, whose name I can't remember. But it was actually a pretty cool one.
Yeah.
And pretty much, I feel like, got reworked into Kanan Jarrus in a way. Rom Koda, that was his name.
Ooh, we can buy our next speed upgrade.
Ooh, where?
Go to your... come to the combat training wing, and you can talk to your, like, class trainer.
Okay.
Also, this is where you can talk to somebody about respec.
I'd need to look at the stuff to see what the differences are.
Yeah. I think it's this side. I'm pretty sure it's this.
I've gotten all really used to just throwing rocks at things.
I think that's the thing, though, is I think you will still have throw rocks at things, but it'll be like your throw rocks at things will do bonus damage, have additional effects.
I know I'll still have like telekinetic throw, which is the channel rocks. I'm not sure. I guess I'll still probably have project, seeing how that was like a level 2 spell.
I think I found your trainer.
God, I love that there's a person here named Edgelord with an E at the end.
Edgelordy.
Let me take that in. Let me equip those. Let me... Kizen does not care for skulls. But he does care for encrypted transmitters. That helmet that we got in there, I actually still can't even wear for another level.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to take a look at it. And my computer's going to think really hard about what this hat looks like. I think I might actually stop the stream here in a second, because we did the flashpoint, and that's really what I wanted to show.
Mm-hmm.
It's a dumb hat. It's not quite the same hat. It's like, what if it was a skin top tight hat that covered most of your head and then also had like dorsal fins coming off the side?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I need to go repair all of my shit, too, while we're here.
Yeah, yeah, I wanted to swing by vendors, because there's, special vendors that sell adaptive gear, and I just want to see if they have cute stuff for level 35.
Oh, I also don't get my speeder upgrade yet. Because I'm a level behind.
No! Okay, can you talk to Master Shanji Vru for respec?
I'm going to look the stuff up before I respec.
No, I just wanted to see if that's the correct person before even all of that.
I'm going to learn my two new spells for Sage.
Hell yeah.
They are Cloud Mind, which lowers my threat, and then Rescue, which is Rescue.
Oh my gosh, does that yank a player?
Yeah, yank a player and lower their threat.
Oh, I love that. Oh, that's good.
Alright, who am I talking to?
Oh, Sean the dude next. Yeah.
No. He just puts his head in his hands.
Okay. Oh, okay, okay. They're close, but not there. They are. Let's see. Nope, that's a PvP mission terminal.
Alright, I'm going to pull something up before I end the stream real quick. I need to look up the name of the song that I want to play and then get copyright strike on my YouTube channel, my first one. I guess technically if I play it over my phone into the microphone, it probably won't get claimed. But that would be a bad way to do it. See if I can pull it up on YouTube. Yeah, a lot of my gear is at 14% durability.
Whew. Okay. This dude is the one. He's... So there's one room for all the specs on the combat wing, and then there's a fifth room that has the respec guy.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. Let's see how this does. Or if it does at all. I don't know how audible it is on the stream.
I'm not hearing it on my end.
Oh, I'm not playing it over my phone. I am playing it just on the stream.
Okay.
It is at least as loud as my in-game volume. Though clearly a little bit louder.
Gotcha.
I'm gonna send the link to you, because it's very silly.
Gotcha.
Alright, that's the stream. Goodbye, stream.
Bye, stream!